again, I want to highlight some of the things that you'll need to have together for this project. Of course, you want to grab your container of friendly plastic pellets. We're using the pellet version. Also have, I'm using the hot water method today. You can still use the griddle method or you can use the heat gun method, but for today I find this project's a little easier using the water. You see a couple globs here. I already have my friendly plastic colored. We'll talk about that in a minute. And it's heating up and getting ready to go. Also have some acrylic paint. This is in burnt umber. I have a stamp, and the stamp that you want to choose, mine has Asian lettering, and yours may have some lettering or an Asian motif that you like, but I particularly like Asian lettering or script lettering for this particular project. Got my needle tool. I have some, these are actually metal stamps. You could use your rubber stamp, alphabet stamps for the project, but I find that these letter stamps, they're about a little less than a quarter of an inch tall. They're very small and it works really well. Then just assemble some, whether it's a key or I've got a gear, some Asian coins, dragonflies, some brass charms, and then I've got my cold pan of water right here. So let's begin. I'm using the water method today and I have my water set on just below a simmer. It's just under 200 degrees and I've already dropped colored pellets into my water, which I'm going to take out right now. I do have a video on colorizing pellets, which essentially is heating your pellets until they're clear and adding a drop or two of paint, or you can use mica powders. You can also use alcohol ink, but in this case I've added a couple drops of green paint and a drop or two of brown to give me a nice sagey green. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just kind of tap out an asymmetrical, I don't want this completely round, form. Oh, I'm seeing that I've been playing a lot in the paint, so my hands are kind of dirty here. The water helps to make a nice resist, and all I'm doing right now is I'm just making sure that the top is completely smooth. Now I'm going to come in with my rubber stamp and I'm going to stamp my impression into the plastic. And you get something that looks like this. Now I'm going to take my needle tool and I want to hollow out a couple of holes here for my wire wrapping, which I just now realized is something that I didn't tell you about in my materials list. So you'll need to get some 20 gauge copper wire. I've done the same thing to this piece of plastic pellets. I have colored them with an ivory color acrylic paint. And I've already begun stamping in the word inspire here. So let me finish that. I have the I, the N, the S, and the P. So let me finish that with the I, R, and the E. So now I have the word inspire on this little shape here that kind of looks like a bone. And now what I'm going to do, again, I need to poke some holes. So I'm going to poke a hole. This is so that my wire can go through and I can actually wire this to my other focal piece there. Okay, now I'm going to drop both of the pieces that I just made into a tub of cold water, and this will cool them down so that we can finish them out. So we have both of our pieces made, and now kind of the fun begins because we actually get to finish it out, and I'm going to antique it a little bit. You can use a cosmetic sponge for this, but I like to dig in with my fingers, and I'm rubbing the acrylic paint deep into the texture that we created with the rubber stamp. This is just acrylic paint, so it'll wash off my fingers. And I do let this dry a little bit because that way it just kind of helps to leave some of it in the cracks. We're going to do this piece also. We're going to do the entire piece, the front, back, and sides of the bone piece. Whoops. We're going to let all these dry for just a minute or two, and then we'll come back and wipe them off and finish them out. The pieces have pretty much dried by now, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a wet paper towel that you can see I've been using it quite a bit. It's got a little bit of brown in it. I'm just going to lightly go over the top surface to wipe away the paint. And this is just leaving the paint in the cracks. So it's just a basic antiquing technique. An idea that you might want to do is you might want to add a little bit of rub and buff in the depressions there. That's kind of pretty. And we'll take off the excess paint off of the bone piece. It's looking pretty good. This is one of those projects that you kind of like to have some imperfections because it makes it look a little bit more realistic. And you can see I've got a few little impressions in here. This is just from it cooling. So I've got my two pieces ready to go. So let's put this together. Now I put a hole in it before it had completely cooled, but you might want to just poke your needle tool through just to make sure that the hole is completely open and ready to accept your wire. And I'm using a wire that's directly off the spool. I've actually applied a little bit of sulfur patina to this. This is Amoco craft wire. It's the copper. And all I'm going to do is I'm just going to insert the wire at the bottom. Or through from top to bottom, and then I'm going to wrap a couple of times around this bone shape itself. Okay, just like this, and I'll come down and finish out at the bottom. I want to leave this tail here because this is what's going to be inserted into the focal part of our piece, and then I'm just going to secure the wrapping by wrapping around that wire a couple different times, and I'll use a pair of wire snips to clip it off. And generally I like to use my pliers to set all the edges down, and if there's any sharp edges of wire I go and file them off. Now, let's attach this to our main piece. So I'm going to insert this into the hole that I created. There we go. Okay. Give it about a little bit less than a half an inch, a little bit more than a quarter of an inch. Bend your wire up and wrap it around itself. There's no wrong way to wire wrap. In fact, this project looks really good when it is a little more organic. Just trim off the excess and press your end down. Now you're going to do the exact same for the other side. Let me show you what that looks like when it's completed. Here I have it all finished out with both sides, and what I've done here is I've actually poked the wire down into the center of the piece, and I've created a little loop. And I wound the excess wire around the loop, trimmed it off. It's the same process that you've seen me do here. And I've attached it to just a plain leather cord with a jump ring. And because this project is pretty organic, I think that the leather cord works really well. Now we can embellish several different ways. And I have different choices I wanted you to see so that you have kind of an idea of how versatile this is. So I could actually glue on a dragonfly to the front. If I want a little bit more of a steampunk style, I could glue on a little gear. It gives you a little bit different look there. And to keep in with the Asian theme, I could glue on a simple Asian coin. Let's take a look at what our finished piece looks like. You can get more project ideas and inspiration on the web at friendlyplastic.blogspot.com. Also visit our sponsor at amoco.com. Online and live classes available through crafttechuniversity.com. You can also friend us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.